the face of overwhelming odds, I'm left with only one option. I'm gonna have to science the shit out of this.
Could the fourth planet from the sun become the place that turns our civilization into a multiplanetary species? NASA is close to sending American astronauts to Mars than at any other point in our history. But the challenges the red planet brings about are monumental to overcome. Yet, the effort to put humans on Mars, and the dream one day to colonize it, are fueling our imaginations to what the future of space exploration could look like. Elon Musk, the chief engineer at SpaceX, thinks it's extremely important for us to become a multiplanetary species in order to overcome a great filter.
This may seem like a mercantile objective, but it is actually the thing that needs to be optimized. Like, there is a certain cost per ton to the surface of Mars where we can afford to establish a self-sustaining city, and above that we cannot afford to do it. So right now, you couldn't fly to Mars for $1 trillion. No amount of money could get you a ticket to Mars. So we need to, you know, to get that, like, something that is actually possible at all. We don't just want to have, you know, with Mars, flags and footprints, and then not come back for a half century like we did with the moon. In order to pass a very important great filter, I think we need to be a multi-planet species.
In ancient Roman religion and myth, Mars was the god of war, and also an agricultural guardian, a combination characteristic of early Rome. He was the son of Jupiter and Juno, and he was the most prominent of the military gods in the religion of the Roman army. Mars was also the divine father of Romulus and Remus. People have also suggested the first city on Mars should be called Nuwa, the mother goddess of Chinese mythology. However, the name doesn't matter really, because there are countless engineering problems that need to be solved to sustain a fully functional city on Mars. Before we jump ahead of ourselves, we can imagine a first settlement on Mars. Elon Musk thinks that we will put the first human on the red planet a decade from now at most. But there is a long list of challenges between the first human on Mars and a permanent settlement. The first residents of a Mars settlement will need to be able to produce food crops in order to sustain, because it's simply too complicated and risky to plan to bring all required food all the way from Earth. They will also need to be shielded from sun radiation. To solve both problems, an international team of scientists have proposed a Martian cliff called Tempe Mensa as the location for a Martian settlement. The cliff is part of Mars's Tharsis region. By choosing this particular location, the group envisions both protecting residents from radiation and exposing them to direct light to grow crops.
What you want to do is you want to introduce warmth, you want to block the ultraviolet so that you can protect organic life. All right, so we have an ozone layer, it's the three oxygen atoms, O3, and ozone likes ultraviolet light. So ultraviolet light comes from the sun and gets eaten by ozone. And when you do that, the ultraviolet light doesn't make it to Earth's surface. So even though they say, oh, wear sunscreen and sunblock 45, yes, that's for the 1% of the ultraviolet that gets through the atmosphere. If you're above the atmosphere, you are fried. So, because ultraviolet is highly hostile to organic molecules and what we're made of as life. So you want to protect, you want to give life a chance. So you want to not only heat Mars, you want to find a way to block the ultraviolet light coming from the sun. So you need some mechanism, if not ozone, or just live underground, for example. And so I don't think we should think of the idea as a literal thing, but just it's a general principle of what you want to accomplish on Mars in doing so. So you want to warm it, you want to protect what could be the future of biochemistry, and then you seed it. And then you wait. You don't want to wait too long, you want to sort of speed it up if you could. And then you terraform Mars.
Of course, the big dream for our civilization is to ultimately terraform Mars. But first, we have to colonize it, and that's more of a daunting task than it sounds. Reasons for colonizing Mars include curiosity, the potential for humans to provide more in-depth observational research than unmanned rovers, economic interest in its resources, and the possibility that the settlement of other planets could decrease the likelihood of human extinction. Difficulties and hazards for this endeavor include radiation exposure during a trip to Mars, and on its surface, toxic soil, low gravity, the isolation that accompanies Mars's distance from Earth, a lack of water, and cold temperatures. Mars's atmosphere is about 100 times thinner than Earth's. Without a thermal blanket, Mars can't retain any heat energy. On average, the temperature of Mars is about minus 80 degrees Fahrenheit. In winter, nearer the poles, temperatures can get down to minus 195 degrees Fahrenheit, although a summer day on Mars may get up to 70 degrees Fahrenheit near the equator. But again, at night, the temperatures can plummet to about minus 100 degrees Fahrenheit. Extreme cold temperatures are many of the big challenges our first Martian settlers need to overcome. To avoid radiation exposure, going back to our cliffside location again, people will have to only visit the more exposed surface when necessary and live in cliffside terraces. They'll need to travel by train and bus outside of the cliffside and by huge elevator systems inside the cliffside.
I think expansion is good, and I think we will expand, and I think we will expand outwards, because there's not much room left on this planet to expand. And when you talk about Mars, especially with Elon, he's right that that's the only place you can go. So there is no other planet we can go to other than Mars. You can't go to Jupiter or Saturn or Venus. So if we want to go somewhere and expand our civilization, it has to be Mars, and everything's there that you need. It is true that there are people who like the challenge. And what is true about Mars? It's interesting, actually, because we know something about the history of Mars now, quite a lot about the history of Mars. And it's certainly clear that there was water, almost certainly oceans, rivers. So, and that water is almost certainly still there. So there's certainly ice. There may even be pockets of liquid water below the surface somewhere. So couple that with all the minerals and the resources that we know are there, and you have everything you need. So that's the thing about Mars. It's quite nice relative to everywhere else other than the Earth. You can't go to Venus. You just melt. It's, what is it, 400 and something degrees and 90 atmospheric pressure. So Mars is quite nice. There are places on Mars. There's a very deep crater called Hellas, which is a big impact basin. And at the bottom, it's so deep, you could fit Everest in it. So you put Mount Everest in there. So you could go there, and at the bottom, the atmospheric pressure is so high that you could just about have liquid water occasionally on the floor of that crater.
While Elon Musk has said he envisions a city on Mars by 2050, most scientists think it's extremely difficult to predict the exact time it would take for our civilization to become multiplanetary. Some have even questioned the validity of the reason to colonize Mars as means to avoid an extinction-level event on Earth. In their view, whatever energy output you need for avoiding any extinction scenario, be it an asteroid impact hazard, rogue AI, nuclear war, the energy output has to be lower than that of building a self-sustaining civilization on another planet. Be that as it may, colonizing and eventually terraforming Mars would be freaking awesome. And no one can argue with that. But let's say we do colonize Mars, overcome any natural challenges that come along, and eventually build a self-sustaining city. How would that civilization operate? What form of government would the Martians implement?
I mean, I would suggest having direct democracy, like people vote directly on things as opposed to representative democracy. So representative democracy, I think, is too subject to special interests and, you know, a coercion of the politicians and that kind of thing. So I'd recommend that there's just direct democracy. People vote on laws. The population votes on laws themselves, and then the laws must be short enough that people can understand them.
Billions of years ago, when the red planet was young, it appears to have had a thick atmosphere that was warm enough to support oceans of liquid water, a critical ingredient for life. In the ancient past, the atmosphere was likely significantly thicker and able to support water flowing on the planet's surface. Over time, lighter molecules in the Martian atmosphere escaped under pressure from the solar wind, which affected the atmosphere because Mars does not have a global magnetic field. 4 billion years ago, Mars was a completely different world. It had blue skies, fluffy clouds, and flowing water. Today, the planet is cold and dry, with no signs of life. So to terraform Mars, we would have to do what nature did in billions of years, only in reverse, and hopefully in a much shorter time frame. Scientists have put forth many ideas to terraform the Red Planet into a life-supporting haven it once was. Some more radical than others, including putting large orbital mirrors that will reflect sunlight and heat the Martian surface, greenhouse gas-producing factories to trap solar radiation, smashing ammonia-heavy asteroids into the planet to raise the greenhouse gas level. According to a new NASA-sponsored study, transforming the inhospitable Martian environment into a place astronauts could explore without life support is not possible without technology well beyond today's capabilities. So the first city on Mars will have to be built on current conditions of the Red Planet, hopefully not too distant into the future. Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing and ringing the bell to never miss videos like this.